What's up, everybody? It's Jet Desert Fox back with another Straight Out of the Box, and today we're gonna be doing something a little bit different. I've already unboxed the product that we're gonna be taking a look at. However, I did want to give you guys an overview of what is included inside the box, and then from there we're going to jump straight into my initial and final thoughts about this product and other products related to it. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Spitfire Tracer Unit and Muzzle Flash Generating Device. Muzzle Flash Generating Devices for airsoft guns are not new by any means. The first time I personally reviewed one was back in 2014. It was the MFG Venom, and that Muzzle Flash Generating Device was a little cumbersome. It was probably around the same size, maybe a little bit wider than the Spitfire Tracer unit, and the battery was external and it was powered by a 9-volt. And so you had this wire coming out of the MFG that you had to figure out where to put this 9-volt battery, and all it did really was just light up. Fast forward to 2021, and we have arrived at the Spitfire Tracer unit, along with a couple others that I'm gonna mention in a little bit, that not only generate a fake muzzle flash, but also doubles as a tracer unit. We've got the Spitfire Tracer here in the box. As you can see, it's just very basic information on the outside. There is a product description on the back, or the underside of the box. For the sake of not having to say both things, I'm just gonna call this a tracer unit. So inside the box, we've got a tracer, we've got the tracer unit and a small little white box. Inside the small white box, a charging cable and a 10/11 millimeter adapter. Depending on what company you're looking at, this adapter is either an 11 or a 10 millimeter. Screw this end into the Spitfire, and then the other end fits into your desired handgun, unless your handgun already has 14 millimeter threading. To charge the Spitfire Tracer unit, simply unscrew the front like so, plug in one end, and then plug this end into whatever, some sort of power source. It could be an external power source or a wall charger, and then you'll charge your Spitfire. The Spitfire Tracer unit sells for about $60 on various airsoft websites. Now, it comes in two versions. You can get one with markings or no markings. I've opted for no markings. Personally, I don't care about trademark kind of stuff when it comes to certain airsoft products. Maybe you want the markings, maybe you don't, but there are options. You can get plain black. Other products come in tan, but again, we'll get into that later. The Spitfire Tracer unit has two modes. You can enable it for muzzle flash and tracer, or just muzzle flash. Powering the Spitfire is a 250 milliamp lithium ion battery, and to turn it on, simply push this button here on the back. When the button is blinking green, that means it's on, and to turn it off, simply press one more time. It'll blink rapidly and then also flash at the front of the muzzle device. As of 2021, there are going to be three options for muzzle flash devices. You've got the Spitfire Tracer, an Acetech one, and then releasing sometime later this year, an EMG Strike Industries Acetech hybrid. Now, each has its own set of different features that are varying from one another. So let's talk about the Acetech tracer unit and how it differs from the Spitfire. Now, I personally do not own an Acetech tracer unit. I have watched a ton of videos, the most helpful being from Jonathan at Airsoftology. If you want to know all about the Acetech tracer unit, check out his video, link in the description below. So with the Acetech tracer unit, you are also looking at a standard 14 millimeter counterclockwise with, and this is in their description, an 11 millimeter clockwise adapter. On the Acetech tracer unit, it'll have Acetech markings. I did not see an option to buy one with no markings, so if you want something that's plain, you can always just spray paint it or cover it with tape or something. The Acetech unit comes in three modes: tracer plus flash. They call it a flame. Flame only, which is just the fake muzzle flash, and tracer only, which obviously is just a normal tracer unit. Now, one thing that I found interesting about the Acetech unit is that it kind of opens the same way as the Spitfire one. However, on the Acetech unit, it's got O-rings on it, so that way water or moisture can't get inside the unit itself. And they say this is just for the elements and also for gel ball. This Spitfire does not. So I'm hoping if I try to use this with a gel ball gun, this is gonna be screwed on there tight enough so water can't get in, but we'll find out. Luckily I have two. The Ace-Tech unit also comes in two colors, black and FDE, or bronze, peanut butter, whatever you want to call this doo-doo-ish color. Releasing later in 2021 will be the EMG Ace-Tech Strike Industries Tracer Muzzle Flash unit. It's basically a collab between EMG, Strike Industries, and Ace-Tech. Even though it hasn't been released yet, there is a little bit of information floating around the internet about the EMG ARMS muzzle flash device. What we know so far is that we'll have two modes, flash and no flash, most likely available with 14 millimeter counterclockwise threading. I'm sure that it'll probably also include the 10 or 11 millimeter clockwise adapter for handguns, because I mean, why not? Ace-Tech already does it for theirs. And since this is a collaboration between the two other companies, I would imagine that they would just do it too, because like, why wouldn't you? Like, this company already does it, Ace-Tech already does it. It wouldn't make any sense for EMG not to do it. The most intriguing part about the EMG ARMS unit is that it has been hinted online that it may also produce its own smoke. I'm not quite sure how they're gonna pull off this smoke effect, but I am definitely intrigued, so yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to pick one up whenever it comes out later this year. That's gonna round up the three muzzle flash devices. Two of them are currently on the market and one will be expected later this year, 2021. So let's jump into the final thoughts and what I think about these muzzle flash devices overall. As I said previously in my MFG Venom one, this is kind of just a huge gimmick for Airsoft. While it is a cool factor, it essentially, yeah, just like every comment that you see about these things just is great at giving your position away. However, there are only so many places that you can hide in an indoor field, which is probably where the majority of Spitfire or other muzzle flash device users will be using them, is indoors. There's not much concealment in an indoor field. You basically just have plywood and more plywood and maybe a crate or a barrel, but I mean, like, nobody makes barrel camo. You're not gonna blend into this 5 gallon barrel in a narrow hallway of a warehouse. Like, don't kid yourself. For all of the keyboard commandos out there that are still gonna be commenting, oh my goodness, you're gonna give your position away, blah 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 blah, here are the two solutions for you. Number one, don't buy it. If you're concerned about giving your position away, don't buy this product. Yeah, it's that simple. Number two, say you are in the most secret concealed position in the warehouse. Maybe it's like a super duper dark corner or something, and you absolutely do not want to give your position away. Your solution is just turn it off. The button's here. It's externally located on the device. Put your hand over this or cover it, and then just simply hit the button, turn it off, and then start shooting people from the darkness. It's not rocket science. Just either don't buy it, or if you want to stay concealed, turn it off. Simple as that. One thing that I kind of noticed when playing with this at very close range at Battle Lab, the light from the fake muzzle flash is actually a lot brighter the closer you are to it on the receiving end, and it does kind of blind you for a little bit. I had some of my friends shoot toward me just to see what it looked like in a GoPro, and in the GoPro it just kind of looks like this very small light, but in the darkness of an indoor field, that flashing light is a lot brighter, and it gives you that effect of, like, you know, when you're indoors and then you go outside into the bright sun and your eyes have to adjust. It's like that, but it's like this constant kind of strobing effect. Obviously, it's not as blinding as a strobe effect flashlight. However, every little bit helps in those in the heat of the moment situations. Now, particular to the Spitfire Tracer unit, which I thought was a humongous oversight, is the glass on the outside protecting the LEDs and the other components on the inside is not BB resistant. And the way I know this is because one of them already got shot out. Why would you not make BB resistant glass for this product that is obviously gonna be shot at? Okay, let's digress a little bit and talk about the color of the flash. All of these three tracer units that are coming out or out right now all have an orange or muzzle flash tint color to them. While this is really cool, I really wish that these LEDs were different colors. Maybe make it customizable. say you've got a green gun with green accents and you're gonna shoot green tracer BBs, how cool would it be to also have a green muzzle flash to go along with that? Or perhaps maybe you've got a red accented gun and you wanna shoot red tracers and also have a red muzzle flash to go with it. Personally, I would love to see way more customization in color in Airsoft as we get into the future. You know, it's something that we see becoming very standard in video games where we've got lots of colorful guns and the gun effects from said guns are also kind of out of this world. Valorant is a great example of that, and it would be great to see that in Airsoft. While we do have the MILSIM aspect of Airsoft, which is geared toward military impressions and such, we also have the like super video gamey, just want to have fun, make stuff customizable and look cool aspect of Airsoft. And I really think that's what's lacking from a lot of these tracer units. So if you would also like to see something like that, please send this video to Ace Tech, EMG, let them know, hey, it would be great to have different color muzzle flashes, or hey, maybe even like a rainbow effect. That would be awesome to see as well. I'm really hoping someone at EMG Arms sees this and can make that tweak to the EMG Arms muzzle flash device before it comes out. That's gonna wrap up this kind of different straight out of the box format. Let me know what you think about different colors or the realistic muzzle flash devices in the comments below. And as always, this is Jet Desert Fox, and I'll see you on the field.
I mean, we're all barrel to barrel. That's barrel. Yeah.
Hey, Brett, don't you have to say barrel to barrel?
Parlay, go.